The letters I and P represent signal types. I represents an electrical current signal, whereas P represents a pneumatic or pressure signal. The I to P transducer is a common conversion device that allows an electronic signal to be converted to a pneumatic signal. I to P transducers are commonly required in process control applications using pneumatic control valve assemblies. Controllers like programmable logic controls, PLCs, or distributive control systems, DCSs, use an electronic output for control, such as a 4 to 20 milliamp signal. These electronic signals are not compatible with pneumatic actuators. If you want the control valve to respond to the electronic control signal, the signal must be converted to a pneumatic signal. That's where the I to P transducer comes in handy. I to P's are available for several different electronic input signals. They may also be configured for different pneumatic output signals as well. So now let's take a look at how an I to P operates. In this animation, we have a 4 to 20 milliamp control signal that needs to be converted to a pneumatic output signal. A common pneumatic output signal is 3 to 15 PSIG. The electronic 4 to 20 milliamp input signal is applied to an electromagnet. As current is changed to the electromagnet, magnetism increases or decreases. This change in magnetism affects the position of a beam. If magnetism is increased, the beam moves toward the magnet, and as magnetism is decreased, it moves away. On the opposite end of the beam is a nozzle and flapper assembly. The movement of the beam positions the flapper in relationship to the nozzle to create changes in nozzle pressure. An increase in magnetism in this example moves the beam closer to the magnet, which moves the flapper closer to the nozzle. And we'll see the output pressure increase from 3 to 15 PSIG as the input current is adjusted from 4 to 20 milliamps. So the output is directly proportional to the input. I to P transducers can be used as standalone devices operating the control valve directly, or they may be used to provide a pneumatic signal to control a positioner. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the classroom.